Today's vlog is called Indian Summer, and it will be a very special Indian summer because we will be recording it in the German village called Gelden. And Gelden is a village where we have our other nursery, and it's about 50 hectares large. And we grow quite a lot of younger trees here. We start with size 18-20 and then up to size 30-35. Soil here is a bit different than the one in the Netherlands that we have in Sint-Oedenrode. This is more loamy, a bit more heavy, but very suitable to grow trees in. And we're going to take a look at some spectacular autumn colors, so let's go into the nursery. Here we have Cladrestis cantuckia, or yellow wood, but you could better say yellow leaves because they extend in their autumn coloration now. Nice tree as a solitary in a park or in a big garden. Cladrestis cantuckia. This is Malus thuringo sargens elegans. Normally you would see this one as a bush growing on the ground, but here they are top grafted, and this will eventually grow into a crown of 5 by 5 meters high and wide if you never prune it. Actually, these are not berries, but these are small apples, and the birds will love them during the winter time. This is one of the most common Liquidambas. It's called Liquidambar sterisflua wurpelsdan. It's mainly used because of its good crown shape. It doesn't get too wide, so you can also use it in streets and avenues. And the autumn coloration is a bit different than from normal Liquidambar. They all get a red, wine red leaf. Very spectacular in autumn. Liquidambar sterisflua wurpelsdan. This is Quercus bimodorum crimpschmidt. It's a hybrid between Quercus robofastigiata and Quercus alba from the United States. And it has the characteristics of two parents. It grows fastigious, and the leaf gets a red autumn coloration, which Quercus robofastigiata never has. Also, it's a very clean leaf. It's October now, and you can hardly see any mildew on this leaf. So it's a very promising tree for the future. It gets about 10 to 15 meters high. Quercus bimodorum crimpschmidt. Another tree from the southeastern part of the United States. This is Nyssa sylvatica. Nyssa really likes to grow on wet soils and can withstand even flowing of water on its roots. And it excels through its excellent autumn coloration. And here also Nyssa sylvatica, but then as a high-stemmed, single-stemmed tree. This is Tilia americana Moltke, a tilia that grows quite fast. You see how big the shoots are. Nice autumn coloration quite early in the autumn as well, yellow. Very large leaves. The tree can grow up to 25 to 30 meters when it gets adult, with a very broad crown. Not so good in small streets, but one of the best trees, nectar producing trees. So it's a very good one to keep up the bee population. Tilia americana Moltke. This is Zalkova serrata urban ruby. And urban ruby, it's already starting the autumn coloration here. And the difference with the normal Zalkova serrata is that the urban ruby is not so wide at the base, so it's better usable as a street or an avenue tree as normal Zalkova serrata is. This is Sassafras albidum. A tree that originates from the southeastern part of the United States. It's really excellent in autumn coloration, and also the leaves are very special because one tree can have different shapes of leaf on one tree. The wood is quite green. Also, when the tree gets older, this still stays green, and also the smell is very spectacular. It really smells like citrus fruit. And also the roots of this tree were used to make root beer. Doesn't get very high, about 10 to 12 meters, and it grows in fertile, well-drained soils. Sassafras albidum. Well, I hope you enjoyed our little tour about the Indian summer. If you still have any questions about trees with a nice autumn coloration, please contact us on the following number. See you next time. Bye-bye.